Good morning, friends. Today we are going to see about the topic organic compounds, hydrocarbons, saturated and unsaturated carbon compounds. First of all, what is organic compounds? The compounds of carbon, except their oxides, nitrates, and halides, other carbon atoms are called as the organic compounds. First of all, it was naturally synthesized. Then it was when urea was during the foundation of urea by Henry Wohler. Sorry, by Frederick Wohler. By Frederick Wohler. He paved the way for the organic compounds. Next, what are hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbon means the molecule that contains carbon and hydrogen alone are called as hydrocarbons, are called as the hydrocarbons. Okay, so these hydrocarbons are divided into two types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated and the unsaturated hydrocarbons. So previously you know that carbon undergoes covalent bond formations, and then under the covalent bond formations there are single, double and triple bond formations. We know that. So the compounds that contains only single bond are called as saturated compounds. Are called as saturated compounds. The compound that contains double bond and triple bonds are called as unsaturated compounds. See, okay, this is single bond. This is single bond. Saturated means that contains only single bonds. Unsaturated means that contains both double bond and the triple bond compounds. Okay, so saturated compounds are called as alkanes or paraffins. The compound that contains single bond is called as the alkanes or paraffins. The compound that contains double bond is called as the alkene or olefins. And the compound that triple bond is called as the alkyne. So this alkene means double bond. Alkene means triple bond. Okay, means triple bond. Okay, understand this now. So hydrocarbons are divided into two types. They are saturated and the unsaturated hydrocarbons. The compound that contains single bonds are called as saturated compounds, and the compound that contains double bond and triple bond are called as the unsaturated compounds. Okay. So while talking about the unsaturated formula, you want to write the formulas. Okay. So what is the formula for alkane and alkyne that you want to write now? Okay. See. If you take alkane, general formula alkane CnH2n+2. This is general formula for alkane. CnH2n. It is general formula for alkene. And it is general formula for alkyne. Alkyne. CnH2n-2. See here. Always don't forget this. Alkane, alkene, alkyne. Don't forget this. This is the ascending order. Ascending order you can take. Ascending order. So alkane and the alkyne. Okay, here, see here. So here, if you put a center one, the alkene. Remember this one, CnH2n. Remember this formula, CnH2n. The for center one is alkene. Above that, you are adding +2, and below that, you are adding -2. So don't forget this. Okay. So for alkane, the formula is CnH2n+2, and alkene CnH2n, and alkyne CnH2-2. Okay, so this is the main formula for alkane and the alkynes. Then we can see in the homologous series also. Again, you can see in the homologous series also. Now, based on this, now we are going to write how these chains are formed. You know what is chains? You know, carbon undergoes formation of chains. So, and the property of catenations. We have seen that the property of carbon. As a form the long chains. So how we are going to write these chains? First of all, if we take butane, what is formula for butane? You take butane means C4 butane. So C4H10 for butane. This is alkane. This is alkane. Alkane and pyrene is butane. So how are you going to write this structure for this now? See, first of all, put this C 1, 2, 3, 4. How many carbons are there? 3 carbons, 4 carbons are there. And again, now fill this for other carbons. So, 1. How many hydrogens are there? 10. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. See here. Now check whether all the because you know that the carbon has tetravalency. So all these carbon have must be satisfied with the four electrons around them. The four bonds around them. Four bonds around them. See here. Each carbon has 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hydrogen has only one. So carbon has 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Each and every carbon has a 4. So it is satisfied. Suppose it is an alkene group. So it is, you can write this for alkane group. This is for straight chain. This is for straight chain. Now suppose if you are going to write for alkene, what is formula alkene? CN, so C4H2N. C4H2N means C4H8. So what is the name for it? This is name for is butene. Name is butene. It belongs to the family, alkene family. Now, how are you going to make double bond? This is an unsaturated. This is an unsaturated compound. Unsaturated because we are going to put the double bond here. So how we are going to put the double bond here? See, C, 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 C. Okay. Then fill all the hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That is equal to. So totally 8 carbons are filled here. 8, so totally 8 hydrogens are filled here. So now check whether all the carbons are satisfied there. This carbon is satisfied, okay. This one satisfied, this one, this is, but this one is not satisfied. This one is not satisfied. Then how can you put this now? He is saying them, this is an alkene. This is alkene. Okay, how can it satisfy now? I can put a double bond here. Okay. One put you have become a what this. See here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can cancel this one. I can put in here. Okay. Here I can put double bond here. See 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. You write and put a 4 right down. Okay. See 1, 2, 3, 4. You double bond on the ring double bond. You can change the double bonds. You can change the hydrogen atoms. You can change the they can put any there, double bond there, depending upon the isomers. That we see in the topic of isomers. Okay. Now suppose it is an alkane. What is form of alkane? C3, we can put for C4H2N-2. C4H6 bold. C4H6. C4H6. So you must have one triple bond, C triple bond, C like this. Okay. How many carbons are there? 1, and put 2. Already is the 3, 4 is there. 3, 4, 5, 6. Like this, you can put the structure. So you can change this isomers here. If you change the structure, means the place means it becomes an isomers. It becomes an isomers. So like this, you want to arrange this for the chains, long chains, side chains. So if you take, you can go for now branched chains. Suppose if you take butane, what is for formula for butane? C4H10 is butane. So already you know that one structure. C like that, you can join now. Like that, now C. I can join the C here. This is one branch one. This is branched chain. This can form any number of branches. Suppose we have 5 carbon atoms. C. We can join here C here like this here. We can join here. But the first, you must be confirm that all these valencies of the carbon must be satisfied. Okay, this is about the formation of the side chain and the branched chains. Now, this also forms the ring. This also forms the rings. How it forms the rings? Suppose it can form more than 6. Suppose C6H6 is benzene. So how we are going to form the chain? First of all, join all the carbons like this. See how many carbons? See, then satisfy with the H. C6H2. Okay, see, we can like this. C6H12. Like this, we can form the rings. So these are the steps. First of all, you must whatever you are writing, it is maybe branch chain, anything. You must write the first carbon atoms with the links. Here is the bond shape, and then fill the remaining hydrogen atoms along the bonds. Then go for satisfying of the carbon. That is whether all the carbon atoms has the 4 bonds around them. Check it then. So if there is any missing, you can put double bond or triple, depending upon the equations or formulas, you can put double bond or triple bond. So this is the main thing. Okay, thank you. Tomorrow we see about the SMS.